algebraic expressions and identities. Before going to the unknown quantities, you should know what is expression, what are the factors, and what are the identities. Is it? Let us learn about this in today's session. The first thing is expression. What is expression? A combination of variables and constants of one or more terms is called expression. Remember, a combination, this is very important thing here. There is combination of variables as well as constants. Okay, variables as well as constants of one or more terms is called as expression. This is an example I have written here for expression. You just see combination. This is a constant and x is a variable. Just because 4 is a constant, we can say it is 4 only. We cannot say 3, 2, 1 like that. Is it? This can never be changed because the number itself is a constant. It has a perfect value. But what about x? There is no value for it. This is unknown quantity. We can pick any number for it. X is equal to 1, x is equal to 2, or x is equal to 3 like that. So we call this as variable. It varies according to the numbers which we give the value. Is it? So this is the constant and this is the variable. When these two combine together, okay? When these two combine together, in one or more terms, this is the first term and this is the second term and this is the third term. Okay, here three terms combined together to form one expression. Okay, this is first term, and this is second term, and this is third term. These three terms combined together to form one expression. So, we can say the expression is a combination of variables and constants of one or more terms. Okay, one or more terms. Yes, my dear students, term means it is each part of an expression. Okay, each part of an expression that is separated by a plus or minus sign. Okay, that is separated by a plus or minus sign. You just see here there are three parts, is it? And two signs, one minus and another one is plus here. You just observe, this is one term. 4x square, this is one term, and 5y, this is another term, and even 10 is also another term, but it does not contain any variables. Okay, it has only constant. The constant number can itself become a term when it is separated by a plus or minus sign. Okay, you just see these two terms are separated by minus sign, so 4x square is one term, and 5y is another term. And here 5y and 10 is separated by plus sign. So 5y is one term and 10 is another term. Okay, my dear students. Now you came to know what is expression and what is term. Okay, what are the terms and what is expression. Now we shall learn about what are coefficients. Okay, what are coefficients. And before going to the coefficients, I would like to say about factors. You just see 4x square, this is one term, is it? This term has two factors. You just see 4 is one factor and x square is another. Got it? 4 is one factor and x square is another factor. Each and every single digit or single constant or single variable itself is what as a factor of a given term. Okay? Each and every single variable or a constant. Okay, single variable or a constant itself is what as a factor. Now, tell me, which are the factors present in 5y? Yes, my dear students, you are telling the right thing. 5 is one factor and 1 is the another factor. Is it? In 5y, this is the one term and this term is formed by multiplication of 5 and 1. By the product of 5 and 1. Is it? So here, two factors are there. 5 is one factor and 1 is another factor. And now we should learn about what is coefficient. variables. Itself is called as coefficient. You just see, you just take first term, that is 4x square. Here, what is the coefficient of x square means? We have to write the coefficient of x square. So, we can write it as 4 is the coefficient of x square. What is that? 4 is the coefficient of x square. Means every numerical thing which is combined with the unknown quantity, that is variable, itself is called as coefficient. Okay, observe carefully. Here it is 5y and coefficient of y is 5. Okay, coefficient of y is 5. Here it is only 10, there is no variable, so 10 itself is a coefficient. Got it? Coefficient means who is in a coexistence. You just think about who is with our co-fellows. We are calling co-fellows means who is by the side of us. Is it like the here 4x square means here 4 is the coefficient of x square. Okay, my dears. Now you have learned about what is coefficient and how we can find the coefficient in a given term. Is it? Now let us learn about like terms. Already you know what are terms. Is it? Terms means these are each part of an expression separated by a plus or minus. Is it? And what are like terms then? Like terms means you just imagine yourself like-minded persons we are saying. Is it? Means both of their attitudes are same, or both of their thinkings are same, or both of are going in the same way. Those are called like-minded people. Is it? And like-aged people means both of them are at same age. So here, like terms means the terms should have a like variables. Got it? I'm not telling about the numerical coefficients or coefficients or the constants. Just you observe here the variable should be like, means same variable should be there and the power should be raised in the same thing. You just see, powers means nothing but exponents. You just see, like terms means 4ab and 3ab. Both of these are like terms. You observe here. Here is also variable a is there. Here is also a is there. Here it is b and it is also b. But the numbers are changed. Is it? We should not bother about the numbers. We should think only about variables. Whether they are same or different. You just, if I write 3ba. 3ba and 4ab. Then these two also like terms. Just because here it is a single b and single a. And here is also single a and single b. They may change their interchange. But the variables are same. Okay, so we call these two terms as like terms. But my dears, if I write 4ab and 3a square b, these two are unlike terms. Okay, these two are unlike terms. Just because you see here is single a and single b, but in second expression it is there is having two a's. A rises to 2 and single b. So, I have already said you that variable should be same and their powers which we have raised or the exponents of the variable should be same. That means, if I write 4a square b and 3a square b, then these two are like terms. Okay? You might understood now? Okay, my dear students. I hope you understood what are like terms. Okay? Then come to the constants. What are constants? Constants are nothing but the numbers. Already I have said you constants are nothing but numbers. Why we call those things as constants means because they can never be changed. If I write here it is 1, then it is a constant. I cannot say this is 4, 3, 2 like that. Is it? Whenever I draw this one, just exactly I can see it is 5. So it is a constant. It can never be changed. So these are called as constants means every numbers or numerical coefficients are called as constants. Okay, my dear students, in this class we have learned about what are expressions, what are terms, and what are the factors. Is it? First one is expression. Expression means it is a combination of variables and constants of one or more terms. It should have one or more terms. Okay? In terms means each part of an expression is called as term and it is differentiated or differentiated by minus or less symbol. And here the term contains factors. Is it? The term contains factors. 4x square means it has two factors. 4 is one factor and x square is another factor. And I have said about coefficient. Coefficient means nothing but numerical numbers or numbers which are coexisted with the variables. Okay? And like terms means that should have a same variables which are rising to the same powers. And then constants means nothing but the numbers which are associated with the variables. Okay? Yes, my dear students, in this class we have learned about the expressions, terms, factors, variables and coefficients. In our next class, we will discuss about the addition of the algebraic expressions. Thank you.